These focus will definitely improve your game in various aspects. The key to the perfect jump smash is, so this important aspect needs to be improved in your game, right? It doesn't matter who you are playing against. You should give your level best and try to win the game even if you're going to lose it. Hey friends, welcome back. This is Harish. In today's video, we are going to do some strengthening workouts related to badminton. These workouts will definitely improve your game in various aspects. And today, we are going to do 4 workouts, and these workouts are based on the important aspects of badminton training. I have given a clear explanation on that topic. If you want that video, the link is given in the description box below. So the important aspects of badminton training are strength, power, agility, and skill. So today's workouts are going to be done both physically and mentally. Now get ready and let's get started. So first workout is for the strength. Strength is not measured by how much weights you can lift or how much reps you can do. Strength is measured by how much strong you are. The tool to get stronger is only the weights. So let's get stronger by doing a simple workout. Single leg split squat. This workout will test your thighs and your calf muscles and give you a great strength to move. Now let's see how to do that. Keep one of your legs on a stool or something like that and the other leg a little far from the stool. Now go down slowly and use the leg on the ground to come up. Do this workout for the reps and sets mentioned in the video here, because if you are doing for the first time, then you should start with less quantity and build more quality, and then you can gradually increase the reps. When you are about to finish one set in that leg, you will feel that burning sensation in your leg. Do not give up and complete the same in the other leg and then take a break. The next workout is for the power. Power can be divided into two, power in the game and power in the body. Power in the game is what you thought at first, the smashes and taps and all. Power in the body is how much power you can give to the ground using your body to jump higher. The key to the perfect jump smash is how higher and sooner you can contact the shuttle. The second is only how deep you hit the smash or where you should hit it and all. Do you know that I have given a video on how you can hit a perfect jump smash? If you didn't know it, then check the video in the description box below. So if you're still here, then let's do this workout first. If you are comfortable with weights, then you can have some. If not, then continue like I do. So first, stand straight, legs shoulder width. And now go down to the squat pose and from there, channel all your power to your legs and jump as much higher as you can. This can look like a simple workout and it can even look like how this is going to give me the height in the jump. But with consistent training, you can jump more and more higher. To prove that to you, I have recorded a jump smash before doing this workout, and after doing this workout, I will do a jump smash and you will see how much changes are there in both the jumps. The next workout is for the agility. If you find the word agility difficult to understand, then I think fast speed training is an understandable word. So as the name says, agility helps you to move fast on court and be spontaneous to every shot in the game. So this important aspect needs to be improved in your game, right? Now let's do the workout for that. Have your racket and keep a few shuttles in the front court like this. Stand in the center and start tapping like this and count till 5, and as you finish, rush to the front court and push one shuttle and come back to the same place and repeat the same till you push all the shuttles. This is a great workout to develop your fast movement you need. Try different variations like pushing the shuttles in the forehand and back and front corners, or in the side corners, or in the back corners. You will definitely see some improvements in your game. And the last workout is for the skill. There are 3 things you should learn to improve your skill: confidence, suitable accessories, and knowledge. Confidence doesn't mean that saying that I'm confident. Confidence is showing that you're confident in your game. You should not fear for anything and just go for what you think. The important thing in confidence is it doesn't matter who you are playing against. You should give your level best and try to win the game even if you're going to lose it. The second is suitable accessories. You should not buy a racket or a shoe based on the best selling or a new arrival or great offers or stylish designs. It should be based on whether you find it comfortable and convenient to play. If you want to know how to choose between rackets and shoes, I have given a separate video for that. You can check the pop-up here or the description box below. The third and last thing in developing your skill is knowledge. You must know what shot you should play at different situations. Because if you do it otherwise, you will either make a mistake and the shuttle goes to the net or outside the court, or you will give a great advantage to your opponent. I have also given a video covering that topic clearly. If you want to know that, it will be down here or up here. And I have given you basically all the important things you need to improve your game. So do these workouts and remember the points while playing your game. If you find some improvements in your game, do let me know in the comments below. I'll be more than happy to know. Like this video and share this to your friends so that they will also know about these things. And I will meet your friends in the next class. Until then, this is Harish. Stay safe and healthy. Thank you, friends. Have a nice week. Peace.
Learning gives creativity. Creativity leads to thinking. Thinking provides knowledge. Knowledge makes you great.